there was some fake news during this period of time about the vaccines, you know, all sorts of conspiracy theories. How did you deal with that, and how did you navigate that, and where do you feel the primary source of this sort of fake news was? How damaging was this to us?
I'm afraid it was quite a lot damaging, and there was particularly with us, we were targeted by a lot of let's say dark organizations that you don't really know the ownership. You suspect that there are some countries behind. We were getting a lot of briefings from CIA, from FBI about attacks that may happen to us, cyber attacks, I mean, but also about the spread of misinformation. You know, there are two groups of people, right? There are the people that they are vaccinated. There are people that are skeptical about the vaccination, and both of them are afraid. Those that are getting the vaccine, they are afraid of the disease, and they believe that because people are not getting vaccinated, they are increasing the risk to them. They are increasing the exposure. So they are, let's say, mad with them that they don't get the vaccine. Those that they don't get the vaccine, they're afraid of the vaccine. And they are mad with the people that are pressing them to get it.
And
there is those I understand. Yeah. They are very good people. They are decent people. That they have a fear, and I understand it. And they don't want to take chances. But there is a very small part of professionals which they circulate on purpose misinformation so that they will mislead those that they have concerns. Those people are criminals. They're not bad people. They're criminals because they literally costed millions of lives.
And should be treated as criminals as well, those who have done that.